One of my main research questions is to understand how photosynthesis evolved in land plants and green algae, and this study provides really interesting clues as to how that process happened. Photosynthesis in land plants and green algae arose more than 1 billion years ago. Plants and green algae can perform photosynthesis because they contain this specialized structure called the chloroplast, where light energy is converted to chemical energy. Even though this is a permanent fixture within plants and algae, it once used to be free-living cyanobacteria, the bacteria that can perform photosynthesis. Presumably, the cyanobacteria were engulfed as food, but somehow they figure out a way to escape the digestion and eventually evolve into this specialized structure called the chloroplast. Without this event, land plants and green algae wouldn't exist, and without the evolution of all those organisms, there may have not been enough oxygen required for the origin and diversification of animals. This idea of bacteria eating behavior has been suspected. However, because much of the land plants and green algae do not have this feeding capacity anymore, we had little idea as to how they acquire the predecessor of chloroplasts in the first place. Symbiomonas is an early branching green algae, which means that it may not have changed that much since that evolved. Previous studies suggested that these algae may still retain the capacity for eating bacteria. However, finding the definitive microscopic evidence for this behavior has been difficult because their bacteria eating behavior may be induced only under particular growth conditions. So this algae can acquire food either by photosynthesis or by chasing after bacterial cells. In our study, we show when there's enough light, they seem to prefer acquiring food only through photosynthesis. When light was limited and photosynthesis became difficult, we saw bacterial feeding behavior. Even before this study, people know that some green algae have these permanent vacuole as well as narrow channel. However, it was not really clear what they were used for. In this study, we showed clear microscopic evidence for it and then further characterized what structures are involved in bacterial feeding. Prey bacterial cells are drawn into these mouse-like opening, and they are transported through the narrow channel and accumulated in the large vacuole where the digestion happens. This research provides clues as to how the ancestor to land plants and green algae acquire the predecessor of the chloroplast. Now we want to investigate this feeding behavior at the genetic and molecular sequence level, what genes are involved in this bacterial feeding behavior. We also want to explore whether other green algal species also retain this capacity to feed on bacteria using microscopic techniques.